And hello everyone, we are back with round number 5. We are here with Shintaro Ito, who finally managed to find his opponent and start his game. So we will be watching him and his mill deck for this round.
Yeah, and yeah, as you already said, he's playing a mill variant, which is kind of interesting. Was brought to the Japanese player from the Japanese players to the OCSC, and yeah, I would imagine they have refined it since then just a little bit, and we'll see what he can do in this matchup. His opponent is playing Malama. Once again, we have Malama on stream, the Spelltech version with the Jirachis, and yeah, not the heavy GX version with the Mirtos, which is like a lot less popular. So see the Esper start from his opponent.
Yep.
And yeah.
And yeah, the mill deck seems to be quite the popular choice for this tournament. Like control, stuff like that is pretty hard to manage in best of one because of time restrictions. For example, Sander Wojcik was one of our featured players who we would have loved to put on stream, but he seems to have had a pretty rough day. He was 1-3 after the last round, so he's I think he dropped. So unfortunately we won't see him and his crazy control deck on stream. However, the mill deck that Shintaro is bringing is quite a bit faster than standard control deck.
Yeah, just he's just opting for like the win condition of this mill deck is like just to straight up deck out your opponent, and Zandas was like get rid of all the resources your opponent has. But Shintaro's like playing towards a very different win condition.
Yeah, exactly. Like Sander, he had like Lycanroc GX in his deck, the one that discards an energy, and he had a lot of energy removal and control. And yeah, I've talked with Sander about control decks, and he said that he absolutely hates like he absolutely hates like boring control decks with just mill stuff. He always wants something that affects the board state, but yeah, something like Beleba and Bryson Man, he hates the card because it just mills three cards and it doesn't do anything to the board, and so he prefers to play something that is that's more, that's slower, that goes for those really grindy long games. And yeah, however, in this format, best of one, 25 minutes or 27 minutes for the game, it just didn't work out for him too well. So
yeah, but one thing I find really interesting like about this format is if I would start to prepare for a tournament that is like best of one, 25 minutes, I personally would not try to check for like any mill matchup or control. I would just go as straightforward as possible, and I think that has been quite popular. So if you're able to use that to your advantage, that people are not playing Oranguru in ADPization, or maybe not playing the Naganadel baby blown package in Mewtwo or Malama, it can give you a pretty heavy advantage if you're able to finish the game in the time. But like if there are players who are able to finish games like this in 25 minutes, it's certainly Japanese players who are used to that and
yes,
just play like tournaments under these conditions like normally. They just play regular like 1.6k people tournaments in best of one 30 minutes.
Yeah.
So they're used to this.
Yeah, it should also be quite nice for them because like usually in their tournaments they play like best of one 30 minutes. If they tie, they lose. And then they have like 9 rounds and they have to go 8-1, and then they might even bubble out of top 16 or something like that. So a very rough format. This here we will have 20 rounds with like basically the same format, so they can allow for much more bricks or just not getting going, stuff like that. However, we have the added variance, I would call it, of playing an online tournament where the internet connection can be an issue. And of course, this is a very new thing, so many things are bound to go wrong and will only be optimized over time. So yeah, they can randomly run into issues that they have no control over, so that would be unfortunate. But yeah, we have the 20 rounds, so even if they lose like two or three rounds because of something they can't control, they can still do well enough.
Yeah, that's certainly true. And you already see like Chintaro's making his actions really, really fast. He knows exactly what he's doing, of course, but that's something you have to do when you're playing a control or mill archetype. You just have to do like your actions have to be almost instant. You have to know what you like. You have to plan your turn in advance, so you only have to do like the physical actions needed, and have everything thought out in beforehand.
Yep, however, not the greatest start for Shintaro. His Malama opponent is already set up decently. No, he doesn't have an escape pod yet, so he still didn't get attacking, but he has a Giratina of free energy, he has a Malama on his bench. And yeah, so if he finds an escape pod or switch here, he can start putting on pressure, taking out this Mareep, while Shintaro, he does have a huge hand, but most of his hand cards are not particularly useful. I mean, he has supporter cards, so that's something. He
Yeah,
always.
so he will be able to draw and see some more cards on his next turn and go for a setup. Like, the Marie package is not really that efficient versus decks like Malama who play four switching cards. And, like, I think it's more efficient towards the end of the game when your opponent might be run out of resources. Maybe he used one or two switches. Maybe you milled one or two switches. And then you can start, like, try to lock them in the active with Mareep and hope they flip enough tails on the sleep flips.
Yeah, here was a really tough mill from Shintaro. I believe he milled two Lily's Poke Dolls, so now he has like three in his discard pile already without having used a
Oh,
single
that's
one.
unfortunate.
Yeah, so that's very painful for him. And he has to sacrifice his Slugma here to get something going, get another Interrupted Sword. So, yeah, definitely things aren't looking too great for Shintaro here.
Yeah, and this opponent will just attack and try to take. Yeah, that's all. The only thing like you can do if you don't have attack for a mill, just attack as fast as possible and hope it's enough, which is certainly not the most optimal strategy.
Yeah.
Like, it's nothing you want to do, but you just have to do it because you have no other option.
Yep. And yeah, Shintaro playing pretty fast here, eyeing up for Mareep. He has a Slumbering Forest in his hand as well.
Yeah,
So
so
yeah.
he could go for a sleep flip, like for a sleep lock this time, which now I like it a lot more because Alex or his opponent is already down to now 20 cards, and if you have to play more supporter cards to get the switch, yeah, you can get into lethal pretty quickly, like the dreaded 11 cards in deck will just go Belelba, Belelba, and then Makargo to win. As the mid player, so yeah.
Yep, now Shintaro considering if he should go for resource management here or if it's better to go into Mareep straight away. But yeah, he goes for resource management, probably wants some Blaze Poké Dolls back. Exactly, that's what he's going for. And yeah, those dolls can come in really handy. He already has a communication and a Pokemon in his hand, so if he can find like another draw supporter or an Oranguru, then he can get access to Lily's Poké right away, and then he can also like after this Oranguru gets knocked out, he can promote Mareep, he ha can attach Balloon to it, and then he basically only needs to find dolls to win a lot of time because yeah, his opponent will be running low on switching cards, he's already running low on deck cards, and he probably has no gusting effect. So
Yeah,
once those dolls are there, they can buy so much time.
that's the issue with Malama if you don't play like the again the Baby Blacephalon package, which like some players have been running, you just lose to mill because you have no hand disruption, you have no gust, and there we see the 6-card mill. So actually Shintaro is only 2 cards away. So probably like his opponent has probably 2 more turns to do something. So even yeah, if he finds just 1 or 2 dolls, this game should almost be over. And yeah, the Makargo certainly helps at doing that. But that means he has to set up another Makargo, another Slugma to find the Makargo GX, or just get
What?
it into the discard pile.
Oh, he sent up Mikago, that's really confusing. I think that probably was a misclick. I
Yeah,
very
I
much doubt
agree.
that was what he wanted. I think he was just confused by this PTCGO reminder that does he really want to retreat or something like that. And then he clicked on the Makago because he wanted to use the ability, and yeah, he ended
That's
up
quite
promoting it.
unfortunate.
Yeah, because like a resource management here, like a smooth over for Lily's Polkadot, and then a resource management would have.
In all it comes down to whether yeah, there's the switch from his opponent, so he be able to string attacks together once again,
Yeah,
and
and
then hold on to two prize cards.
that
And he
is
actually
really
has 12
painful.
cards left in deck. And yeah, I don't know how many Palpites Shintaro has access
Yeah,
to shuffle
exactly.
back
Like
when he
he really
rivers.
needed the resource management last turn to get like po to get Paul Pets back and prepare for big mills. And that misclick was very unfortunate. However, he still has his Mareep and he still has a couple of Lily's Polka Dolls, so maybe he can win some time.
Yeah, just play down the dolls, retreat into them, and then try to recover some resources and get to the rest of your deck. But he's also running low on cards, so with the 10 cards left, you have to be able to, like you have to be careful and see what resources do you have able access to. He has just one Palpite in his discard pile, so they are
Perhaps.
still. Oh, he's only playing two Palpites, so he has only access to one more Palpite, so
Actually,
that's
perhaps he sacrificed for Makago on purpose because now he could recover the Slugma and can evolve it into Makago GX the next turn. So maybe that's also what he wanted to do. But he does have Mewtwo in his deck, so if he just manages to discard the Makago, he can copy it with Mewtwo GX. So I'm not sure, but it's definitely
yeah.
not that bad.
Yeah, true, true. He's definitely still in this. I just think that, like, we're going for the Oranguru there would have been a little bit cleaner. Like, would have given himself a little bit more options on the following turns.
Exactly, if he was just able to recover a couple of Paul Pets, then he could have used like his Makago and combination with Station to like get what he needs for a couple of turns and use those little Polka Dolls to win quite a lot of time.
Yeah, now if his opponent is able to just oh he whiffed the switch. He whiffed the switch card that is huge in this matchup. If you're not able to get out of the sleep, that loses you crucial turn of time. If Alex would have been able to go down to just one prize card, that would have been really scary territory. Because then you can maybe start pinging the Mareep with stuff and go for an Esper knockout maybe or something. But two knockouts is way harder to achieve.
Yeah, with Mareep not having any damage is pretty good for Shintaro. If it has 60 HP, and I believe Espo does. Oh no, Espo does 20 per each damage counter, right? So if 20
So he
damage.
would have,
Yeah, so
yeah.
he would need two damage counters on it. So the Mareep is still quite safe, I guess.
Yeah, the Mareep is still safe. Yeah, he would have needed two turns anyway to kill the Mareep, but it's like worth to go for it rather than try to attack through two dolls consecutively, I think. Now Alex is at 13 cards. I don't know how many Cynthias he has left. It would be kind of interesting to see. Yeah, so oh, there are four Cynthias in his discard pile. Thank you very much, Shintaro.
13 cards
So
left.
probably two more turns, so if he's able to like somehow get a knockout on the next turn. But he has bench locked himself, so that's also quite
Nothing he can put down anymore. Yep.
yeah.
And jeez, can Shintaro please tick the box to not show this anymore? Alright, so yeah, Shintaro now in a really good position where he got a lot of stuff left, of course, if Alex can find Switch. But yeah, he can't even keep attacking, so those dolls and the Mareep putting in a lot of work. The Mareep putting him to sleep
Yes.
once again.
Yeah, Mareep is such a good card. Actually, I think it also, Mareep in Mill is not that popular, but I think it also performed really well in the seniors division at the last international. So I think there was a Mill deck with Mareep, which came like second or something. So at least
And
top
yeah.
eight. So unusual, but it works out really well.
And yeah, and there we are. One prize, 11 cards left, and Shintaro has everything he needs to take the game. He will be able to evolve into Mechago GX, use two Belebba Brisenmen thanks to Lieutenant Search, and then mill the last five cards with Mechago.
Yes, and that's the game. That's just
And yeah.
how it goes when you play Mill and your opponent doesn't have any counters. The only thing they can do is just hope that it works out for them, but a lot of time it's not enough. And Shintaro is still refusing to tick the boxes, but it doesn't matter. And he wins by deck out. Yeah, really fast, pretty clean. I think the one turn was a little bit iffy, but yeah, he knows what he's doing. So that's why he's like 4-1 and I'm sitting here just rambling, so he probably knows.
Yeah, a very cool game, I think, in general. I don't like the Chinchina mill deck too much, but I like the Mechago mill much more, because where you kind of like don't play as aggressively, I feel like. I mean, both decks work on setting up your deck the way you want, and then using in the late game Lily's Poké Doll plus a lot of mill back to back to back to back to back until it's game over. So they are kind of interesting. They always look a bit shaky in the early game, and then in the late game they just mill so fast and finish it so quickly. So
Yes.
always interesting, but yeah, I personally definitely prefer the Mechago version that Shintaro is playing, just because I think smooth overs, like, I mean, trade basically is of course great, the ability of Chinchino, but I think picking a card is always more interesting than getting random cards.
Yes. Cherry picking one is definitely really, really good.
Also, it has the side benefit of not being of having the Slugma, even if your Mewtwo is prized. So then you still have access to the Mechago GX attack, GX
Yes,
attack, so.
you only play one stage one lane essentially when you only play Mechago, and then you have also you have the like the basic support with the Mareep to maybe buy you a few more turns, which worked out in this game. It worked out perfectly.
Exactly, and Shintaro, I'm not 100% sure what score he has right now. I think it's something like 4-1 or 3-2. It's a bit hard to say because the Smash GG pairings are really not optimized for like third-party views. So for the player themselves, they can see their game quite easily because it's right at the bot at the top, and they just click on it, are right in their match. So if the servers work and they can connect, there shouldn't be any issues with that. On our side, however, finding the pairings is really hard because, yeah, we kind of have to search for the player and then find the games there, go into the games from that, and everything is split into pools and not synchronized. And yeah, it's just really hard from a third party to look into those pairings. So I can't say 100% what Jintao scores right now. Yeah. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this match. Those two matches actually we had for round five. Even though it's hard to count Magnus' game as an entire match because it took like 2 turns. Not even, I guess. But yeah, we will go to a quick break and we will hopefully be back soon with round